Coming up on the lakefront, famed author Sandra Cisneros speaks at OLLU, activist Lydia Cacho shares details of her experience as an activist, and students share their opinions on the presidential debate. Next on the lakefront. Hello, welcome to the Lakefront. I'm Chancellor Makanjuola. Last Wednesday, OLLU welcomed renowned author Sandra Cisneros, who gave a free reading open to the public in Theory Auditorium. Reporter Denise Coronel was there and got the opportunity to speak with Sandra.
The OLLU familia gathered to welcome award-winning author of The House on Mango Street, Sandra Cisneros. She recently received the National Medal of Arts Award by President Obama for enriching the American narrative. Aside from the readings, there was also a book signing in which fans got to meet her.
I honestly thought it was really inspiring and really open and passionate. She was really cool and awesome.
She was amazing. I've never read the books. I've never done this before. So like coming in with like a fresh plate or a blank slate or whatever, like coming in and like hearing her speak, just her stories are incredible and they're motivational.
Sandra promoted her latest book, House of My Own, and I had the opportunity to speak with her about her visit to the campus.
We know you get invited to a lot of universities, but what makes the OLLU familia special to you?
Well, you know, I used to have workshops here with my Macondo, and I was writer in residence for a time when there was the big fire. You know, I offered my readings, so I came and gave readings. But just walking down the halls, being in this auditorium, I remember when the poet I came and performed here, and Andre Crudescu, people like that, of that magnitude, that performed here. And our Macondo writers performed here. I performed here. I just have great memories. It's almost as if I went to school here, and in a way I did. But our Macondo workshop, we brought Elena Poniatowska, we had great people. So as I go down the corridors or come down this auditorium, me da como like chills, you know, to remember, oh, this happened, or this writer was here, and this writer is no longer here, like she's in the spirit world. But I remember she gave one of her last readings right on that stage. And it's a homecoming of sorts to be here.
Well, there you have it. Sandra Cisneros at OLLU. You can purchase her most recent book, House of My Own, in stores or online today. Reporting for the Lakefront, I am Denise Coronel.
The Saints Production Board hosted a game show in Chapel Auditorium where guest speaker David Coleman gave advice to students on relationships and money management.
My name is David Coleman. I'm known as the dating doctor around the world. And I talk about dating relationships, romance, sex, marriage, divorce, mutually beneficial, wonderful, respectful relationships. And SPB brought me into campus today to do one of my programs. I'm doing something basically tonight called Dating and Relating in a Title IX World. I think people will really enjoy it. And I'm here because SPB was nice enough to invite me to campus. My relationship with the movie Hitch is Sony Motion Pictures hired me to promote that movie all over the world, which I did. And what Will Smith does in that movie as a date doctor, I do every single day of my life. Like, he had Kevin James. I have 10 Kevin Jameses in my life at all times. And honestly, on my drive over here today, I had conversations with two of them. So I do 150 to 200 live shows like I'm doing on campus tonight. And then I have 10 to 15 clients a year, just like Kevin James in the movie, that I help with their relationships.
Looking to increase your spiritual connection? Then the Awakening Retreat is just for you. You can find applications to attend the trip under the Faith and Service tab as soon as you open the OLLU homepage. The retreat will take place from November 11th through the 13th, so make sure to reserve your spot. The fee is only $20 and can be submitted to the campus ministry located in the Elliott House. The FAFSA application is now open for the 2017 to 2018 school year. Students and families can use their 2015 tax returns on the online form. The deadline to complete the form is March 15th, but students are encouraged to get a head start by applying early. Please contact the Financial Aid Department for more information. Up after the break, Donald Trump visits the Alamo City and Hurricane Matthew affects the U.S. East Coast. Next. The SAPD has caused some controversy after Donald Trump's visit to San Antonio on Tuesday. SAPD officers are facing discipline for wearing Trump's signature Make America Great Again caps when they greeted him at the SA International Airport. According to city policy, employees of the city are not allowed to support political movements while on duty. Trump came to the city to host a fundraiser that was by invitation only. We are now less than 30 days away from the presidential election. On Sunday, presidential nominees Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton faced off for the second time. The debate took place at Washington University in St. Louis, Missouri, and it was moderated by CNN's Anderson Cooper and ABC's Martha Raddatz. Spectators deemed the debate to be a fiery one, with each candidate making jabs at each other on their past transgressions. Republican nominee Donald Trump addressed controversial remarks he made years ago in a leaked recording about groping women, while Hillary Clinton responded to allegations made against her husband during his presidency. The final debate between the candidates will take place on October 19th at the University of Nevada in Las Vegas. So what are your thoughts on the presidential debates? Reporter Justin Chapman ran around campus and asked students for their opinions.
We're here today getting people's opinions on the presidential debate on Monday.
There are some questions that I say weren't answered as much as I wanted them to be. For example, how women aren't paid as much as men are yet. I don't think that was answered enough. You know, they didn't specify a lot about what they plan to do on that.
Like, in terms of conducting yourself in a presidential manner, I feel like Hillary Clinton definitely was a lot more professional than Donald Trump. But in terms of policies, I felt like Donald Trump was a bit more clear. There were definitely some issues he skirted around, but then again, there were some issues Hillary did.
It was okay. I think it could have been better. I wish he could have answered actually the questions when they were asked instead of fighting with each other.
It was okay. It was too entertaining. It should be more informative than entertaining.
And these were some of the opinions that we had from our OLLU students here. If you have any other comments, you can make them below. And reporting for Lakefront, this is Justin Chapman.
Thanks, Justin. Remember, your vote is your voice. Early voting in Texas begins on October 24th. San Antonio is mourning the loss of activist Choco Meza, who passed away on Sunday due to a battle with cancer. Meza was a well-known political activist in San Antonio's West Side and a Democratic Party organizer. Recently, she was an organizer for Hillary Clinton's campaign headquarters in San Antonio. The Democratic nominee tweeted out her condolences over Meza's passing. She was 64 years old. Hurricane Matthew has claimed at least 27 lives in the U.S., with 19 deaths in North Carolina. The hurricane was downgraded to a tropical storm but is still causing damage to some areas. Search and rescue efforts have been underway in North Carolina due to heavy flooding in the region. Hurricane Matthew has also caused serious damage in the Caribbean, with Haiti being the most affected. The death toll on the island is now over 1,000, and many fear the flood damage could worsen the cholera epidemic in the area. If you would like more information on relief efforts or would like to donate money, then please visit unicef.org. Coming up after the break, JC has your entertainment fix and Gabby catches you up on Saints Athletics. Stay tuned. Midterms are coming up and students are probably looking for ways to stay sane and relaxed. JC is here to bring you the latest in movies and games that could help take a little pressure off your mind for a bit.
Entertainment section of the newscast, where I like to make outdated reference. Okay, watch me make outdated reference. Okay, oh, ooh, watch me. Ooh, anyways, I've got some new movies and games to talk about, so let's get started. And action. A man and his family are as close as can be. The dad has a new job on an oil rig, and the daughter wants him to bring back a genuine dinosaur fossil. Aww. The man kisses his wife goodbye, and he heads out deep over the water onto the horizon. At Deepwater Horizon. He starts his new job, and wow, in the first 10 minutes of the film, he finds a genuine dinosaur tooth. He Skypes his wife to tell her that everything at the highly dangerous, potentially explosive, heavily foreshadowed, deadly oil rig is going perfectly, and that there hasn't been any issues, and it blew up. Deepwater Horizon is an action drama slash documentary based on the tragic oil spill in the Gulf of Mexico. Starring Mark Wahlberg, Kurt Russell, John Malkovich, and Kate Hudson, this film has an award-winning cast that I'm sure won't disappoint anyone who likes action dramas slash documentaries. Gonna be honest, I really don't like action dramas slash documentaries. The plot can literally be summed up with a tweet and plenty of room for 3 hashtags, and I really don't care about the characters, and I haven't even seen it yet. However, I say this every time there's a movie I know I won't like, it doesn't mean that you won't. If action dramas slash documentaries are your thing, Deepwater Horizon won't let you down when you see it in theaters now. And now onto a movie with a title longer than Deepwater Horizon's plot. There's a new world coming. Charles Xavier has a home and school built for gifted youngsters. Wait, wrong movie. Miss Peregrine has a home and school built for peculiar children. What makes them peculiar children? Why, the peculiarity gene, of course. It's a recessive gene that gets passed through families like it's literally X-Men. It's X-Men for kids. Origins of the story aside, the story of MPH-FPC is that there are peculiar children brought to the orphanage where they can play and learn and discover more about their peculiarity. Fortunately for the first class of peculiars, Miss Peregrine has the whole orphanage in a time loop, allowing them to live out all the days of their future pasts. However, the orphanage isn't completely safe, and what feels like an apocalypse is setting in as the children are being hunted by Morgan Freeman for reasons, and all the kids must come together to make their last stand. Look, it's a Tim Burton movie, it'll look pretty, and that's all we really expect from him at this point, really. Ratings for this movie have been pretty good, and I'm personally excited to see it. I think it's going to be a pleasant film with great visuals and interesting characters. You can see Miss Peregrine's Home for Totally Not X-Men knockoffs in theaters now. Okay, let me be real for a second. I want a Vive. Have you seen what the Vive can do? It can simulate a full area for you to walk around and experience in fully enriched VR. The amount of creative uses for VR with the Vive is insane. Of course, the VR experience of the Vive was an improvement on the Oculus Rift. Well, now PlayStation has had some time to work on their VR headset, about 3 years, so it's now time for Sony to show us what deep and immersive storytelling VR can give us to the award-winning game Until Dawn. A game, I remind you, is regarded for its storytelling and its branching story, not to mention its scare factor. Introducing Until Dawn, Rush of Blood. Wait, what the heck is this? Is this a linear on-rails shooter? They took the game praised for its storytelling and made you shoot things. They took a game with a branching story and made it linear. They took a controller-only game and made it only available to the PSVR. This thing costs more than the PS4 itself, coming in at $500 if you buy the bundle that has all the stuff you'll need, like motion controllers, a PlayStation camera, and so on. However, to give credit to Sony, it is currently the cheapest and most reliable VR experience on the market compared to the Vive and Oculus, so credit where credit is due. Critic reviews of this game say they beat it in under an hour and a half, with the jump scares being plentiful, if not a little bit annoying at times. It's scary, but don't expect Until Dawn gameplay. Instead, you'll be shooting things on a clown roller coaster. I don't know quite how I feel about this game. It's expensive, especially if you don't already own a PlayStation, let alone a PlayStation VR. Are you getting a PlayStation VR headset? Got plans to get one? Leave a comment down below. Rush of Blood pretty much is only using the Until Dawn name to give it brand recognition. It comes out this Friday, so if you've got $400 to $500 burning a hole in your pocket, you can get yourself a PlayStation VR headset and use it to play Until Dawn, the disappointing spinoff. Just be sure to get some other games for it. Well, that about does it for this week's entertainment segment. I hope to see you guys next week and the next for our spooky, scary Halloween specials. And cut.
Thanks, JC. A Saints coach reached a milestone last week. Reporter Gabby Cavazos has that and more in sports.
Thanks, Chancellor. We had some strong showings last week from the Saints Athletics, so let's get started. Women's soccer got their first ever win against crosstown rival St. Mary's last Tuesday, 2-0. Erica Robertson and Grayson Manfredo provided the goals, and senior goalkeeper Gabby Lopez got the clean sheet. The women also got back to conference play on Thursday with a 4-0 win over Jarvis Christian College. It was the sixth straight shutout and 10th of the season for the Saints. On Saturday, the Saints won in Tyler against Texas College by the score of 11-0. The team is 11-2 on the season and returned to the pitch this Thursday as they host Houston Tillotson at 1 over at the OLLU soccer field. Men's soccer also had their East Texas swing this last weekend. Coach Shane Hurley picked up his 100th victory as the men's coach at OLLU when the men came away with a 3-0 victory over the Bulldogs of Jarvis. Coach Harley also has 57 wins from coaching the women's team before Arthur Salazar took over the coaching duties in 2013. The total of 157 wins is the most all-time wins for a coach in OLLU history. On Saturday, the men's soccer team continued conference play in Tyler against Texas College, who the Saints were in tie for first place with. That game ended in a tie after double overtime. Volleyball extended their home match winning streak to 22 games on Tuesday, knocking off Shriner in four sets. Saints senior Kendall Groff led the team with 10 kills. Saints volleyball hit the road last Thursday, taking Houston Tillotson in Austin and won in four sets. The Saints are now 6-1 on the season in conference and will take on the Rattlers at St. Mary's tonight at 6. Saints will return home on the 19th against Trinity at 6 o'clock for that one. Saints cross country competed at the UIW invite on Saturday, and the men finished first out of 6 teams. The women finished third out of 4. Both teams will compete next week at the Mid-States Classic hosted by Southwestern University in Kansas on October 22nd. The preseason Massey computer rankings came out on Monday for men's and women's basketball, and the computer system has both the OLLU men and women ranked in the top 5 of the NAIA. The women are ranked 3rd behind Mid-America Nazarene and Baker University. The men are 5th behind Georgetown, LSU, Alexandria, William Penn, and Biola. The official NAIA coaches poll for basketball won't be released until October 24th. Remember, if you have any comments, post them below. And that was a look at your Saint sports.
Thanks, Gabby. As always, don't forget to like us on Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Also, feel free to leave a comment down below. From all of us here at the Lakefront, I'm Chancellor Makanjuola. Thank you for watching and see you next week.